this demonstration, you're going to use Notepad++ to demonstrate identifying and removing non-printing characters. And Notepad++ is one of the softwares that's included on your flash drive. So this afternoon, when you get to the exercises, if you decide to work on this exercise, we'll help you install that application. Notepad++ is very, it's similar to the Notepad that you already have on your PCs, only it has a lot more functionality and features. So it is a free, open source application that can be downloaded from the internet and installed. Like I said, we've provided it for you. And we've been using this to help us identify when we receive data sets that have things in it that we can't figure out why lines may be breaking, things like that. As we go through this, you'll see that if you have a really large data set, some of this might be impractical, and then that's when you start to evaluate other options like scripting some of this functionality. So John already has Notepad++ open, and we already have a data set open. We're going to use this same data set a couple of times today. We're going to use it in the taxonomic name resolution session, and we're going to use it in the session we do with more with Google Refine. Sure. John has suggested that we open it in Excel so you can see how it might look if you were to open this file in Excel. We chose this file specifically because we know it has a lot of particular things in it wrong with it. So, in Excel, one of the first things that you can notice if you scroll over to the county field, you can see down on lines 8, 7, 9, 9, 6.
It's everywhere.
Everywhere. We have characters that look weird. This county should say Doña Anya, and the diacriticals did not encode correctly when it was opened in CSV. So Excel was not able to correctly identify that this was UTF-8. So and at this point in Excel, it's very difficult to fix this. Is there any way to fix it?
A lot of work.
It's a lot of work to fix something like that in here. So if you were to do that as receiving data from somebody, you would have lost a lot of valuable information from them. So instead, we open it in Notepad++. And if you look to those same records in the county field, you can see Doña Anya looks correct. It doesn't have the extra character in between the two fields. And that's because it recognized that it was UTF-8. If you look down on the status bar, you can see that it says ANSIA UTF-8. There's an encoding menu that also tells you what it translated as. If we were to switch the encoding to the ANSI option.
In other words, if we were to look at it the way Excel does.
It would look like it did in Excel with the weird extra characters. Actually, it would look slightly different than Excel. Or is that the same? It's the same as it was in Excel. So as we start to look at some of the functionality in here, if we look at the edit menu, there are a lot of features that you can do to help clean up your data. There is an option to convert case. And we're not going to do that one right now, but you could see if you had a lot of data that was upper or lower case and you needed to switch it, you could use one of those options. There, the next and look at line five. Line five is a completely blank row. No data in it, and it doesn't, there doesn't appear to be any reason why that is there. So we're going to use that functionality in the edit line operations. And we're going to choose the last option where it says containing blank or empty lines, or blank characters, yes. And it immediately removes that blank row on line five. And it would have done if there had been any other sentence in the file. Okay, next, we want to start looking at whether or not there are any other issues in here. So we're going to go to the view menu. And we're going to click on the show symbol, and we're going to click on show all characters. Now, for what you can see right now, it doesn't appear that anything has changed. But if we scroll to the end of the line, you'll see that it is now showing the line feed characters at the end of each line. And we do want those at the end of each record. But if we scroll back to the left and we start to go down our file, we start to see that on line 55, we have a whole series of lines that don't appear to be full records. Yes. So John's going to look at it in Excel. And in Excel, you're not going to see it. Because if you go over to 54, go over to that field. This particular data set has a lot of loan fields. Try The reason that in Excel you don't see the individual lines like you did in the text file is Excel actually allows line returns within a cell. So yesterday when I was talking about data considerations and I said considering the tools that you use for Excel where you can unintentionally inject data issues, this is one of those where in Excel if you come to the end of your line in a cell and you hit Control Enter, it starts a new line for you in that same cell. That is something you do not want to do when you have data that you're thinking about publishing. So that's why in Excel you wouldn't necessarily find this. Yeah, and it took us a while to find it, you know, stem cell, making bigger and taller. And then if we continue to scroll through the file, we'll see there are two more sets exactly like this. So we are going to go and clean up those three sets. sets. So we're going to go to the end of line 54, and we're going to select lines 55 through 69, making sure that we capture the line feed characters. And then we're going to click on the search and replace. We are going to find for a new line value, which is a backslash and an N. And then we're going to replace that with a semicolon and a space. So that would be the preferred method for a field like we just saw. Instead of putting a new line, you would take your data, put a semicolon and a space in order to create a long string of the data that is separated with the semicolon and the space. You can see their individual entries within the field. If we were to use a comma in that, it would potentially throw off your data since the field is a comma delimited file. Yes. Other options that we're going to select the in selection box because we only want to look at the highlighted section on the screen. And then we're going to choose the search mode for the extended, which allows us to do unseen characters like the new line or a character term or a tab character. And then we are going to click, we have several buttons to click on over on the right, and we're going to do the button for replace all. If we only do replace, it would only do the first selection. So it finds 16 instances, and we click OK. And now we go straight from line 54 to line 55, and it looks like it should in our record set. One of the other things, this file started with 150 records, and now we're down to 133 lines. We can see that on the status bar. And yesterday I also mentioned that it's important to know how large your data set should be. So this data set ends up being 100 lines, and we started with 150. So if I were to try and publish that, and I was getting 150, and I knew I was only expecting 100, I would know something was wrong. So John's going to do the same action for the next set, where he's going to select it, click on search, and find it. Place and a new line. It remembers all the rest of our selections. He hits replace all. See, this is why I made John do it, because I kept de-highlighting everything every time I tried to click on something else. I need a mouse. So this is what happens when you say replace all in document. Instead of it overlooked that we had this collection highlighted, and it actually wiped out everything in the document because it decided to look for every new line. So these are things you might encounter. If that happens, just immediately get out of there and hit undo. Or close and don't save. We have another 16. And then we have one last set to clean there. And the last 16. So now if you look, we are down to roughly lines. We have 101 lines. And that first line is our header row, so we have 100 records.
Are there any questions about what we've shown here so far? the idea, the big difference here between this or Notepad or Excel is that we actually can see the content of the data or the file that you can't normally see. You can turn on the things that you can't normally see. So if you had a tabbed unlimited file, you can see where the tabs were, they would actually show up. Or I think I can show them by putting a tab in or something also. Yeah, so it shows up as an orange arrow. So the nice thing is that with this, you can get in and find out exactly what's causing a